and you report only to me alone. Bjarki was suddenly frozen. The word Jarl was spinning around in his head. He'd never imagined such a high honour, in even his wildest dreams. I know what you would say, said Widukind, that this land is now mostly under the control of the Franks. Indeed, you may already know that they are building a great fortress at Sigiburg, a bastion to guard their road, the Hellweg, the artery along which their legions march when they seek to despoil Saxony. These lands are not mine to give. That's what you may say. Bjarki was in fact pondering his new title, Bjarki Bloodhand, Warden of the First Forest, or Jarl Bjarki of the Three Rivers. But he had the wit to keep his mouth shut and just listen to the Saxon speech. You would be right to make this valid objection, said Widukind. But I'll give you 600 people, good warriors all, a mix of Saxons and Danes, and a few others to take Sigiburg Fortress from the enemy and to garrison it with our own people. I shall be engaged in the west, in the stolen lands, but I will give you this small army to cut their highway, the Hellweg, in South Saxony, and keep the Franks out of our lands. Your lands. My answer stands, said Bjarki, summoning all his reserves of will. You're not yet persuaded. I can see that, Widukind continued. You fear you will become Galala, I believe is the correct word, like your father Hildar, whom you had to kill. I know the story, you see. Valtir told me. But let me tell you this. You knew my father. You knew he was a wrecker of the Boar Lodge. So answer me this. What age was my father when he died? Bjarki pictured Theodoric in his mind, a hefty, red-faced, oldish fellow. 60 years, he said. He had seen 64 summers when he died on that very spot right there, said Widukind, pointing over the rampart at a patch of grass near the edge of the Mark Channel, a mere 100 paces away.